Mr. President, did you give an order to strike Khan Sheikhoun with chemical weapon last Tuesday?
Actually, no one has investigated what happened that day in Khan Sheikhoun till that moment. As you know, Khan Sheikhoun is under the control of al-Nusra Front, which is a branch of al-Qaeda. So the only information the world have had till this moment is published by al-Qaeda branch. No one has any other information. We don't know if the whole pictures or video that we've been seeing are true or fabricated. That's why we asked for investigation into what happened in Khan Sheikhoun. This is first. Second, Al-Qaeda sources said that the attack happened at 6:30 in the morning, while the Syrian attack in the same area was at around noon, between 11:30 to 12. So it's, they're talking about two different stories or event. So there was no order to make any attack. We don't have any chemical weapons. We gave up our arsenals a few years ago. Even if we have them, we wouldn't use them. And we had never used our chemical arsenal in our history.
So what happened this day?
As I said, the only source is Al-Qaeda. We cannot take it seriously. But our impression that the West, mainly the United States, is hand in glove with the terrorists. They fabricated the whole story in order to have a pretext for the attack. It wasn't attack because of what happened in Khan Sheikhoun. It's one event. It's a stage one, the play that we saw on the social networking and on TVs, the propaganda. And the stage two is the military attack. That's what we believe is happening because it's only two days, 48 hours between the play and the attacks, and no investigations, no concrete evidence about anything. The only thing were allegations and propaganda and then strike.
So who, according to you, is responsible about this alleged chemical attack?
The allegation itself by Al-Qaeda, al-Nusra Front, so we don't have to investigate who. They announced it. It's under their control, no one else. About the attack, as I said, it's not clear whether it happened or not. Because how can you verify a video? You have a lot of fake videos now. And you have the proof that those videos were fake, like the white helmets, for example. They are Al-Qaeda, they are al-Nusra Front, who shaved their beard, wore white hats, and appeared as humanitarian heroes, which is not the case. The same people were killing Syrian soldiers, and you have the proof on the internet anyway. So the same thing for that chemical attack. We don't know whether those dead children, were they killed in Khan Sheikhoun, were they dead at all? Who committed the attack, if there was attack? What the material? You have no information at all, nothing at all, no one investigated.
So you think it's a fabrication?
Definitely. 100% for us it's fabrication. We don't have arsenal. We're not going to use it. And you have many indications if you don't have proof because no one has concrete information or evidences. But you have indications. For example, less than 2 weeks, around 10 days before that attack, the terrorists were advancing in many fronts, including the suburbs of Damascus and Hama, which is not far from Khan Sheikhoun. Let's suppose we have this arsenal, and let's suppose that we have the will to use it. Why didn't we use it when we were retreating and the terrorists were advancing? Actually, the timing of that attack, or alleged attack, was when the Syrian army was advancing very fast, and actually the terrorists were collapsing. So why to use it if you have it and if you have the will? Why to use it at that timing? Not when you are in a difficult situation, logically. This is first. Second, if you want to use it, if you have it, and if you want to use it, again, this is, if we suppose, why to use it against civilians, not to use it against the terrorists that we are fighting? Third, in that area, we don't have army, we don't have battles, we don't have any, let's say, object in Khan Sheikhoun, and it's not a strategic area. Why to attack it? Well, what the reason? Militarily, I'm talking about military from a military point of view. Of course, the foundation for us morally, we wouldn't do it if we have it. We don't have the will because morally this is not acceptable. We won't have this, the support of the public. So every indication is against the whole story. So we can say that this play that they staged doesn't hold together. The story is not convincing by any means.
With the US airstrike, Trump seems to have changed his position on you and Syria drastically. Do you have the feeling that you lost what you have called a potential partner?
I said if it was conditional.
Yeah.
If they are serious in fighting terrorists, we're going to be partner. And I said not only United States, whoever wants to fight the terrorists, we are partner. This is basic for us. Basic principle, let's say. Actually, what has been proven recently, as I said earlier, that they are hand in gloves with those terrorists. The United States and the West, they're not serious in fighting the terrorists. And yesterday, some of their statements were defending ISIS. They were saying that ISIS doesn't have chemical weapons. They are defending ISIS against the Syrian government and the Syrian army. So actually, you cannot talk about partnership between us who work against the terrorists and who fight the terrorism and the others who are supporting explicitly the terrorists.